Hello friends, in this session I am going to demonstrate you passing array to function in C language. So we can pass array to function in C by using two ways. So the first way is we can pass array to function by passing individual elements of array to function. Getting, and the second way is by passing entire array to function at a time. Getting, so no need to pass individual elements of array. Getting, so the second method is useful, or second method is convenient. So instead of passing all individual elements of array, you can pass entire array at a time. Okay, or in a single go you can pass entire array. So second method is useful, but I will first show you first method and then we'll see second method. Okay, so let us start with passing individual elements of array. Getting, so passing array to function by passing individual elements of array. So let us see the program for same. Okay, so first declare header files. I'm going to read elements of array from user, so I may require printf and scanf. So that's why I have included yesterday.io.h, because printf and scanf, they are available in yesterday.io.h header file. Next, I have defined main function, which is entry point of every C program. Getting, and main should return zero value, because as per Dennis Ritchie's suggestion, main should return zero value because zero indicates success. Getting, so as we are returning zero value and zero is integer, so I have specified the return type of main as integer. Getting, now next we require array, so declare array. Suppose I am specifying the size of array as 5. Getting, so this is array declaration. Now I am going to read elements of array from user. So enter 5 elements. I am keeping this static for this example. Enter 5 elements of array. Getting, and then we'll read these elements. Now I am using here for loop. Getting, so you know that array index always starts with 0. Getting, so I is equal to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus. So here I am going to read array elements one by one. So percent %d, comma, and a of I. So see, first element will be read and that will be placed at address of a of 0, then address of a of 1, and so on. Getting, so last element will be placed at address of a 4. Getting, so with this you are able to read array elements. So this is runtime initialization of array. Now we got our array. So let us see the diagrammatical representation of this. Consider we have this array which has 5 elements, first, second, third, and then suppose fourth. And the name of array is what? A. Name of array is A. And consider this is memory of main function. Or we have declared this array in main function. So this array is known by the main function only. And then consider we have read these values in 30, then 40, and then 50. So consider this is the current scenario. We have main function. Inside main function, we have created one integer array of size 5. Getting, and these are the indices. So 0, then here 1, then 2, then here 3, and last is 4. So name of this block is a of 0, name of this block is a of 1, and the name of last block is a of 4. Getting, So array index always starts with 0 and it ends at size minus 1. So this is current scenario. Now consider we have one function called display. We have one more function in our program, display. Consider I want to pass this array, this 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 to display. Getting that is our point, passing array to function, because this array is present with main function. Display don't have this array. Getting, so I want to pass this array or these array elements to display. So there are two ways. First way is by passing individual elements, that means 10, pass 10, print, then come back, pass 20, print, again come back, pass 30, print, again come back, pass 40, print, again come back, pass 50 and print. This is the first method, that is passing individual array elements to the function. And the second method is in single go, you can pass all these 5 elements to the function. So that is more convenient. So we'll see first and then we'll see second. Getting, so continue this program. So we require one function display, which is going to print these elements. So see, at a time we are passing one element of array, so I'll require one formal parameter. Okay. And see, here I'm calling display function. So at a time I'm passing one element. So how to take array elements? So see, how to take first element. So 10 is present at a of 0. Second element is that 20 is present at a of 1 and so on. So every time I need to take this element. So I will require loop here to pass these 5 elements. So I will place this function call inside function, inside for loop. Getting, then I is equal to 0, then I less than 5 and then I plus plus. And here I need to pass actual parameter as a of 0. So see how it will be executed. For loop will be executed, I is equal to 0, 0 less than 5 condition true, it will go inside this for display a of 0, that is it will take 10 and that will be passed. Okay, then that will be passed. Now your function definition will be outside main, and we have already seen there will be one formal parameter, so that 10 will be collected in number. Getting, and then we are going to print that. We are going to print that. So 10 will be suppose slash n then number. Okay. So see the execution. First the I is equal to 0, then 0 less than 5. Condition is true, it will go inside for loop. Display a of 0, that is 10, that will be passed. So this is function call. So from this point, compiler will jump to this function definition and it will brought that 10 value that will be copied in number. Getting, and then that will be printed. Now the execution of this function is finished. Again it will come back to this point. Again it will continue the for loop. So again I plus plus. So if previously I has 0 value, so 0 will be incremented by 1, so it will be 1. Now 1 less than 5, condition is true, again it will enter into for loop. So display a of 1, again it will copy that value to number, it will be printed and so on. So here what is the drawback of this method? Here 5 jumps are required and 5 return jumps are required. Getting, so here the time will be more, execution time will be more as compared to the second method. Getting, so that is the drawback of this method. We are, every time we are passing individual element, we are printing that. Once the execution of function definition is finished, again we are returning back to the main function. Again we are calling function. So 5 jumps are required and 5 return jumps are required. So that is the drawback of this method. Getting, so see, display has this number. So every time this number variable will be created. So see, this 10 value will be, 10 value will be copied in number, it will be printed. Again we are coming back to this we are copying we are
coming back to main.
We are copying this 20 inside number. Okay, inside number, then again we are printing that. Again we are coming back to main. We are copying 30 inside number. Again we are coming back to main. We are copying 40 inside number. Again we are coming back to main. We are copying this 50 inside number. And with this, all in elements of array will be printed on your output screen. Getting? So now let us see the output. New elements. Okay. So this is the output of passing array to function by passing individual elements of array.